We were just talking about you. We've been feeling a bit guilty for troubling you about the persimmon tree. Oh, good one. I wouldn't worry about it. Glad you can joke around even at a time like this. Makes me feel like we're not so different, you and I. Lord knows I can't pass up a good pun. That persimmon tree is a reminder of our son. Actually, before his death, he was a teacher at GeckoCon. He planted that tree on graduation day with the students of his very first class.
Just when we thought that tree was about to bear fruit. Why now? Why do they want to cut it down now? Thank you. I'm all right now. That made me feel a lot better. It's very comforting talking to you.
Oh, wow! You've really gone and captured my wife's heart. You must be popular with the ladies. My wife's no sucker, after all. I feel I'm looking at myself when I was in my prime. Don't fret too much about the tree. Just stop by when you have the chance. Oh, and take this. It's left over from earlier, but it's still good. Well, then...
Welcome back. Yes.
Sorry, I kept you waiting. Yeah, sorry, I guess I need to train more. Whew. It's going. I'm super thirsty. Oh, that was great. I always say food tastes better with a buddy. I used to come here all the time with my teammates, but... I'm the only one who says that anymore. Anyway, they wouldn't come now even if I invited them. I don't really get along with people who don't take the sport seriously. They even started training at different times. Nothing's organized anymore. I used to love it there, you know. I spent all my time on the track, practicing and training. We all loved track and had so much fun together. Then... never mind. It doesn't matter. We're too different, them and me. I'm going to reach heights they never will. I have to. I think I'll do. You keep at it.
Pleasure. And that's why... Yes, that's right. So the answer was pretty obvious.
It's nice to meet you. So, you said you needed to talk to me?
Yeah, keep your hands off our girlfriends.
All I've been hearing her talk about is Ryoji-kun.
Yeah, you need to stop talking to every girl you see.
Oh, sorry. I actually have no idea which girls you're talking about. There's been too many that have come up to me.
What? Is this a joke to you?
I'm sorry if I offended you, but I haven't made any moves on anyone. I just invited them out for a bite to eat.
That's exactly what we call making a move!
That's a problem, then. I've made a promise to go out with them. I can't just cancel due to my inconvenience.
Quit messing with us!
Give me your phone. I'm gonna delete all the contact info you have. Who the hell are you? This is none of your business.
Are you taking his side?
Hey, it's that guy from 2F. I heard he's friends with Sanada-senpai and the student council president. They live in the same dorm. What do we do? If he tells them, then...
Look, just stay the hell away from our girlfriends and delete them from your contacts. Got it?
All right. I'll do it.
Better watch out, or he'll steal your girlfriend, too.
Sorry. I didn't mean to make trouble for you. Guess so, huh? I really didn't expect them to be so angry. Right, from now on, I will ask if they have a boyfriend first before inviting them out. Hey, thanks for having my back. You're very kind. What a great view. The ocean looks so beautiful. I do like seeing it from the monorail to school each morning, but it looks so different from up here. I wonder why those guys were so mad. If you're in a relationship with someone, that means you like each other, right? I don't think me getting in the picture would change that, would it? I wonder what it means to like someone. Do you have someone like that? Is that how it is? Well, maybe you can tell me once we get to know each other better. I guess there's still a lot that I don't understand. Look at the world out there. The people in the city, our classmates in school, and you. I want to know more about all of it. Alright, since I dragged you into this mess today, let me make it up to you. I'll treat you to ramen. I just had some with Junpei-kun the other day. And while we're at it, maybe you can show me around town. I'd like to know what kind of places you like going to.
I see you're back.
A girl, ain't it? Even though you're still sponging off your parents? Well, like father, like son, I guess. You! What the... All this time, I thought you were... I guess my eyesight is getting bad after all. Spending all my time with clients, missing anniversaries, birthdays. I wonder if they felt the same way I did. I was waiting for you earlier. My wife and son. We were all together back when I was still a businessman. It's already been 4 years now since they left me. We used to stay out past midnight all the time. My wife and I would always fight about it. Now when I go home, I don't know what to do with myself. Oh, I just come here and drink every night. Of course not. They're the ones that abandoned me, you know. Besides, after all this time, I don't know how to face them. She hasn't contacted me since then. Must have gotten over me already. I have no idea where they are, or if they'd even want to see me. It's too much of a hassle. All right, kid, enough of the depressing talk. Let's get out of here. I want to go home and take a shower.
Morning.
Hey there.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Sorry, but I don't think I can make it today. I'm really sorry. But actually, my mom fainted. I'm at the hospital right now. They said it's exhaustion, since she works from morning till night.
Damn it! It's all my fault. And my mom, she's trying to leave. She says we can't afford the medical bills. God damn it! Why can't I do anything? I'm useless. I'm just another one of her problems.
I'm sorry about all that. I don't want to be a problem for you too. But I'm glad you were the one to hear me out. Talking about this kind of helped.
Oh.
back to her room, so...
You are. Finally found you.
Hey, Takeba.
You hardly ever miss student council meetings. I've been looking all over for you.
Did someone ask you to come find me?
Well, yeah. I'm not a member or anything, but still.
Ah, well. Sorry about that.
You've been pretty busy, huh? What with the class trip and all. It's for both second and third years, so I imagine you have your hands full, too.
The class trip. Even if I did go, I'd only spoil the fun.
Wait, you're not thinking of skipping the trip, are you? You can't do that. That's not an option.
Hmm?
You know, I've been meaning to talk to you.
About what?
Well, honestly, you're not the easiest person to relate to, but I lost my dad too, and I know what that's like.
Takeba.
So I've decided I don't want our friendship to be over. I'm going to be more upfront with you from now on.
There she is! I've been looking everywhere for you.
Huh? Ryoji-kun? Why are you up here?
Huh? Weren't you looking for Miss President, too? I was doing the same thing. Some guy asked me to find her. He said if I didn't, the class trip might get canceled.
Odagiri-kun. He'll hit up anyone in arm's reach for a favor.
In any case, looks like I found you, Mitsuru Kirijo-san. And I have to say, you're quite stunning. Maybe we could go out sometime? I know this place on the top floor of a five-star hotel. The restaurant up there has a view of the city nightscape that's almost as breathtaking as you.
Nightscape?
Senpai, you better head back to the meeting.
Oh, right. Takeba, thank you for coming to find me. For now, I'd better see to my duties.
Hey, she left without giving me an answer.
For now, huh? I don't like the sound of that.
Well, how about you, Yukari-san? Care to join me for dinner? I know this place on Shirakawa Boulevard. Ow!
Like.
many choices. What do I pick? A special ramen bowl and an extra large side of rice? I am curious about that one, but it sounds like a lot of food. You'd offer to eat that? Then the only thing I'd have is the big bowl of rice. I think I'll just go with the regular set meal. Okay, I'm ready to order. Oh, that was really good. It had a strong flavor, but went down so smoothly. Food from a restaurant always tastes so amazing. You know, before I moved into the dorm, I'd never really eaten out that much. My parents always said that eating at home would give me more time to study. And whenever we ate, that's all we'd talk about. My upcoming tests, my post-graduation plans. They even factored that into my diet. They said certain foods would boost my focus. I don't really remember how any of it tasted, though. I was always too high-strung to notice. I really didn't want to disappoint my family. That's why I tried so hard to meet their expectations. But all they ever said to me was, "Try harder." I was never good enough for them. And I think that's a big reason why I never had any confidence in myself. Oh, you know, the gyoza here was really good too, wasn't it? Lightly crunchy on the outside, but soft on the inside. I'd like to try making some myself one day. Plus, I bet it would be fun to make it together with someone. Oh, but I'm not quite ready for that yet. I'd probably make so many mistakes. You think so? But if it doesn't come out well, wouldn't I just be wasting everyone's time? I'm a little afraid that it might turn out like that, actually. Oh, say, could I ask you for one more favor? I'm thinking I'll take this opportunity to study how to make gyoza, like the ones here, just so I have more options when cooking for everyone.
Welcome back.
Hey. said, hey, 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 fueling the fire with the burning desire. Every day wears by it, but never expires. But we will chill today, let me ride the world tomorrow, yeah.
Marvelous. I'm looking forward to it. Come to think of it. Here are my requests. Very well. Welcome to the Velvet Room.
I please choose the personas you would like to fuse.
Is this acceptable? This one is somewhat beneath you. Is this acceptable? Are you finished? We look... Oh, yes!
Yeah.
Yes. Negatory. Take it down if you can! We can hit a weakness with this!
A shadow. What will you do?
Found the stairs! Oh, there's a treasure chest!
That chest doesn't look like the other.
Ah! chest. Koro-chan's yawning. That's a rare sight. We could head back, but it's your call.
Careful, the enemy's nearby. It's a treasure. Shadow, what will you do?
Found the stairs!
There's no room for carelessness. Stay alert. A shadow, what will you do?
It'd be easy to lose sight of a golden shadow here.
Yeah, seriously. It's all glitter and shine here. Let us know if you spot one, though, okay?
We have to stick it out for just a little bit longer. Hang in there.
There's a shadow. That teleporter can take us to the entrance. Try to remember where it is.
This floor has been fully explored now. Koro-chan is sniffing the floor. I wonder if a shadow was just here.
We found the stairs. There's a shadow.
Ooh, maybe there's something.
There's a treasure chest.
What? Yes. Welcome back.
Good day. Very well.
I trust you're not tired. Then let's be off.
Patterns again? Psychedelic? Oh, there's a treasure chest!
Yes, we got the advantage!
I'm still setting up. It'll take a little more time.
Teleporter can take us to the end.
Hey there. Oh, there's a treasure chest. The patterns here makes me uneasy. So did the other floors.
Excellent. Looks like we can head up.
This is seriously making my eyes hurt. It's too dangerous to look away.
I won't miss my chance.
They're looking very strong.
Yeah.
ambushed. What should we do about the door?
Could it be?
Maybe it's just me, but I get the impression that the motif for each block in Tartarus is fear.
Well, this place definitely gives me the creeps. Who in the world would design something like this?
There's a shadow.
You take the initiative! Very strong! I have to do this!
Where it hurts.
Do the trick.
Go for it. Let's go to Lega.
doesn't seem to be effective.
In this situation,
Shadow, what will you do? That chest doesn't look like the others. There's a treasure chest.
All right. No shadows detected.
Good. This will make me more effective in battle.
Looks like this at night. Proton's guard is up! It's dangerous! Stay on guard!
Shadow, what will you do? We don't...
distracting, but let's try and keep an eye out for shadows too. Proton's guard is up.
Let's do this.
Oh, Kirijo Senpai's been poisoned!
Trigger.
Can someone fix it?
Shadow, what will you do? Kirijo Group will continue to support our activities. It's a treasure chest. time to hit me.
Bad. You dodged it!
I'll go
with her, leader!
Move to strike.
I'll hit them where it hurts.
I'll show you! I won't lose! Last one! Let's finish this!
Shall I move to strike? This will do the trick.
Thank you.
out there.
Anything in that area? So fast. You'd never guess from the way they look.
That's just one of the many things that make them weird and creepy.
Let's do this.
Didn't work!
Oh no! Kurojan's down!
This isn't good.
Welcome back.
Accepted. Are you accepting a request? Wonderful. Let's hear the results. I will await a report of success. Very well.
We're doing well. Let's keep up the pace.
I think Kuro-chan found something. Kuro-chan found a one-way teleporter to the entrance. You can do it, Kuro-chan!
Is that...
Fog therapy must be really effective. Considering how Kuro-chan makes me feel. No, not that. Here's what I found. Woo! Watching your health and stamina? Remember not to push yourself too hard.
What's the plan?
Excellent. Looks like we...
Oh, there's a treasure chest!
This is where the stick...
Koro-chan seems really focused on the designs on the walls, doesn't he?
Excellent. Looks like we can head up.
During winter, the sound the arrow makes when it hits the target is so satisfying.
Maybe it's because of the temperature. The air feels cleaner and crisp during winter.
A shadow. What will you do?
Hey, there's a treasure chest. Look kind of different from the...
Shadow, what will you do?
Oh, can we go up those?
Leader!
What to do.
Hecaton Fire!
Move to strike.
Now's the time. Pull the trigger.
Welcome to the Velvet Room.
I too. What kind of person?
You can't control this one yet. This would be a wise choice.
This persona is powerful. This persona is powerful. This would be a wise choice. This would be a wise choice. Is this acceptable? Is this acceptable? This persona, yes. This persona, yes. Is this acceptable? Is this acceptable? This persona, yes.
It is a special persona you desire, is it not? All of this will almost certainly be worth your time and effort.
A wise choice. This would be a wise choice. This persona is powerful.
Take all the time.
You can't control this one yet. Persona, yes? This power might be too much for you. This persona is powerful. This would be a wise choice. Are you satisfied with this? This persona, yes? Are you satisfied with this? This persona, yes? This one is somewhat beneath you. This persona, yes? This persona is powerful. Registering, I see. Will you register it to the I've completed registration. Is overriding acceptable?
influence.
Please choose the personas you would like to fuse.
This would be a wise choice. What skills to inherit?
Well then, shall we?
This persona is powerful.
Shall we take a look?
This would be a wise choice. This would be a wise choice. What do you wish to inherit?
Powers have been bestowed upon you.
This persona is powerful. This would be a wise choice. This would be a wise choice. This persona is powerful. This persona is powerful. What do you wish to inherit? Thank you.
It appears it will receive an immense amount of power.
It's finally time. This power might be too much for you. This is your progress so far. Please take a look. Is this acceptable? Very well, it's yours. Now then, let's begin.
Which will you choose?
This would be a wise choice. What do you wish to inherit?
It appears it will receive a good amount. Why, this is exciting, isn't it? What kind of persona do you desire?
This would be a wise choice. What
do you wish to inherit?
It seems no new power. Well, well, well. Like it did not turn out the way we expected. Take all the time you need to consider. Which will you choose?
This persona, yes? Are you satisfied with this? This persona, yes? Are you satisfied with this? This persona, yes? This one is somewhat beneath you. Is this acceptable? What do you wish to inherit?
It appears it will receive a good amount of extra power. It appears it will receive a good.
It's finally time. This persona, yes? Are you satisfied with this? Are you satisfied with this? Are you satisfied with this? This one is somewhat beneath you. You can't control this one yet.
Is this acceptable? Are you finished? We look... Wonderful. Wonderful. Of course. How splendid. By all means. The look in your eyes. It's strong, fierce. A far cry from how you looked the day we first met. Then... you have my thanks. Very well, then. Good day. I shall be waiting then. Here are my requests. The look is... very well then.
Amazing commodity!
I'm going to do it. Good, good. Not bad, kid. Thanks, kid. Bye-bye.
you got? All right, I'll take that. What'll it take? As long as you need. You finished? Come back soon.
Good day. Are you accepting a request? I've been waiting for you. So, this is your current domicile, the student dormitory. So this is your room. I've never seen many of these items before. If I might be permitted to ask, when I made the request to visit your room, did it make you a little suspicious? In truth, there is something I wanted to tell you. During my forays into your world, I encountered a great many things. Every single one of our outings is a treasured memory, each one a polished, glittering gem. Walking around the crowded Port Island streets, sampling the local cuisine, idling the hours away at the shrine, even visiting your school for a day. And I came to a realization. I had been subconsciously requesting to visit locations that were more and more central to your life. And today, I endeavored to visit the one place in your world where I could learn the most about you. That is the reason as to why I requested to visit your room. If I may be so bold, do you recall the day you gave me a tour of your school? There was a moment where I mentioned that I felt very fulfilled when I touched you. It was the first time I'd ever felt that way. I thought to myself, why did I feel so fulfilled? But after coming all the way here, I finally found my answer. I believe it's because I had the chance to walk in your shoes. Those of us who reside in the Velvet Room wait with great anticipation for our guests. Their arrival is our only link to the outside world and gives us a reason for being. When I'm together with you, I can have that all for myself. Let me put it more plainly. I'm rather naive to the ways of your world, and there must have been many times when I behaved quite strangely. However, even I understand the significance of inviting a gentleman into his own room. If you wouldn't mind, I'd love for you to guide me through it. Thank you. As if I've become an entirely different person compared to when I first set foot in your world. If I stay on this side any longer, I fear I will forget my duties entirely. But I understand that wouldn't be ideal for you. That is why I am drawing the line. No more visits here. I shall remain on my side. Thank you very much for acting as a guide on my journey of discovery. I am truly grateful. Now then, though the sorrow may be sweet, let us part. Are you accepting a request? Wonderful. I'm looking forward to it. Of course. You have my thanks.
Very well, then. Welcome to the Velvet Room. Are you in?
Have you all the elements you need? Will almost certainly be worth your time and effort.
Are you finished? We look forward to...